Okay, welcome to my tutorial on how to map the keypads in your Arturia keyboard. In my case, I have an MKII Keylab61. So those pads normally will map out accurately in a variety of programs, but the software by Reason and their particular instrument called Kong has been a bit troublesome. I went to the Reason site, did quite a few searches, and in my example here, you can see that I did find a correct map. And I'm going to illustrate this in detail, and I'll do the very best I can to make this work for you. So in finding this section on the Reason site, you'll see that the pads have to be mapped accordingly in the Arturia controller. Let's disregard this whole section here. I put a couple of notes up here for you as examples, but I will further demonstrate how this works. So on the pads on your keyboard for Arturia, the notes you will be selecting are C1 for the first pad, C#2 for the second pad, and so on, all the way to the end, and the last one will be D#2. Let me show you this a little bit further. I'm going to go ahead and open up the Arturia controller right now. And in doing so, I'm going to delete the template I have here previously so we can start fresh. Okay, so once you've opened up your MIDI Control Center by Arturia, you're going to go ahead and click New at the bottom. And go ahead and type Kong if you like. In my case, I'm going to put Kong 3 since I'll be putting this in the user profile number 3, and I'll show you that in just a second. So go ahead and do that. Hit the enter on your keyboard so it's labeled as such. And once it shows up as Kong or Kong 1 or Kong 2, whatever you like, in my case again it's Kong 3, go ahead and click the very first button on the Arturia MIDI controller, and that is actually button 1 on your keyboard, however, using this graphical user interface. Down at the bottom, you can change the colors as you go along if you like. I'm going to leave all of these on this color here just for simplicity. But the most important thing is that, as I had mentioned earlier, pad number 1, you can see it's highlighted, must reflect this value here, C1. If it's not, and it's something else, the Kong pads and the Reason pads will not communicate accurately. It'll be somewhat of a mess and will take you quite a bit of time. I left my channel on channel 10. That seemed to be fine. You may have to change yours depending upon how yours is set up. You can go through the Arturia instruction manual and figure out how to change your channels on your actual keyboard to match up here. But for this purpose, we're going to keep it on channel 10. Let's go to the second button, which is pad number 2 on the Arturia keyboard, and you'll see it's C#1. That is actually correct. If you click on the third one, it's going to be D1. That's correct. The fourth one is D#1. The fifth pad will be E1. Sixth pad is going to be F1. Seventh pad is F#1. Eighth pad is going to be G1. Ninth pad will be G#1. Pad number 10, you're going to map that out to A1. The 11th pad is going to be A#1. 12th pad is B1. 13th pad should reflect C2. 12th pad, I'm sorry, the 14th pad should be C#2. 15th pad, D2. And finally, pad number 16 should list as D#2. Go ahead and save those changes. Mine is already grayed out because I've saved this earlier. Yours should be highlighted in this area, so just go ahead and click Save. Now, the last thing you want to do is up here, is if you have not utilized any of the user settings on your actual keyboard, then you could simply drag the template you just made into user number 1. In my case, since I've already used up 1 and 2, I'm going to simply drag it to user number 3. Now you can follow this as well. You'll just pick number 3, that is user 3 on your keyboard. So once that oblong square or rectangle is highlighted, as you can see, just drag and drop and then let go. If you see this, that means the data is being transferred from that new template you just made here up to user number 3 in my case, or whichever user you have chosen. Now, since MIDI controllers cannot be open in more than one program at once, so in other words, you don't want to have this open in Reason, we're going to have to close out of this. And now we're going to go into the Reason program. It's opening. Once Reason opens, you could start with a brand new template and just go ahead and drag the Kong drum designer in here, and then it will open up. In my case, I've already done this. I don't want to create another track or another session for Reason. I'm just going to open up the one that I already have in place. Okay, so now with the MIDI controller by Arturia closed, we are now in Reason, and we're going to go ahead and check our settings for Kong. So now I took the Kong settings, and since I modified them just slightly, I gave mine a brand new name. And if you do the same, you're going to click this button here to save it. This is where you save the patch once you've modified it. That will save your patch so you can use it versus the default. So when looking at these pads, the way they're laid out, I map mine the same way the Arturia keyboard is mapped out. So as you can see, in Kong, it's actually pad number 13. However, I didn't prefer that. I actually wanted mine to be the same as the Arturia keypad. So as you can see, it's number 1. And down here is number 1. So you basically click this to match up with this. So once the two are showing correctly, I'm tapping mine, and I dragged and dropped the bass drum patch in there. And as you can hear, it's working. Now that's with a mouse click. I'm going to walk over to my keypad and illustrate the same. Now on my keypad, on the Arturia keyboard, number 13 should kick off the bass drum. But on screen, in Kong, it's showing as number 1. I haven't gotten that far yet as making them absolutely 100% identical, but I'm completely okay with this. So when I hit 13 on the Arturia keypad, the number 1 shows up here. Ideally, I really don't care about this because I'm going to be tapping away on the Arturia keypad. So once that's done and you're getting sound, I just want to show you that some users may be going through this unnecessary setting here. Let me show you mine. So when I'm on pad number 1, and by the way, to change the name, you just simply double click this, and you can type whatever you want. Then hit enter, and then it saves the name under the keypad. So with 1 and 1 being selected, there's not really much in this interface that you have to do. The work is already done in the MIDI controller. But if you did want to double check, let me show you what mine looks like. I'm going to click this edit button here. Then I'm going to right click on number 1 so you can see what's going on behind the scenes. And when I choose this, you'll see my setting. It just changed on the fly, and that's incorrect. I'm going to cancel out of that. That was unintentional. Try this again. Right click, go edit. And your settings should look like this. No override mapping. Learn from control surface input. You want to make sure if you're having any difficulty that all 16 of your Kong pads show this exactly. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and cancel out. I'm going to disable this. And then as I scroll through here, you can hear the snare drum. Now on my Arturia keypad, once again, I have that mapped out to number 14. So number 14 is going to play my snare. Of course, you can assign that any way you want. So here's an illustration. I know you can't see this, but I'm tapping number 14 on my Arturia keypad, which should trigger pad number 2 in Kong. And it does. So that's pretty much it. All 16 of these are done. I had encountered quite a few obstacles, both with instructions from a variety of sources that were all incorrect. This took me about 5 hours, and I hope this will just take you 10 minutes and will save you a great deal of time. Thanks for watching, and any comments would be great. And if you have any questions that I can answer for you, please put them in the comments section below, and don't forget to click like. Thanks again, and have a wonderful day.